now come back to a forest from Kashmir. And it was a time in 1969 that she was all tired. Asked me my favorite prayer was. At that time I'd never heard of her from that before. And I had no idea. I just prayed this. But I had he'd asked me to telegraph something. You know, 48 prayers of what she came in with. And so then I asked him what his favorite prayer was, and he immediately said, And I said, well, what's that about? And he said, well, it's a prayer that a great thing I was trying to do. And so this is what the translation to this prayer is in this particular song book edition. O Lord, hurry, I have wasted my life. Although I have taken this rare human birth, I have not served Radha and Krishna, and I have known this drunk poison. The treasure of divine love in Goloka Vrindavan has descended as the congregational chanting of the Lord's holy name. Why did my attraction for that chanting never come about? Day and night, my heart burns in the fire of the poison of worldliness, and I have not accepted the means for believing it. Lord Krishna, the son of the king of Braja, became the son of Sachi, and Balaram became the Thai. The holy name delivered all those souls who were lowly and wretched. The two sinners, Jagai and Madai, are evidence of this. O dear Lord Krishna, son of Nanda, accompanied by the daughter of Rishabhanu, please be merciful to me now. Narottamadas Thakura says, O Lord, please do not push me away from your reddish lotus feet, for who is my beloved except you? Then it is roughly the melody that Srila Prabhupada sang the song, and it's impossible to copy him, because this prayer I heard him sing 5 times, and last time I was in 1972. And in 1970, and one time when he was singing this prayer in Kashtanga, he went into a kind of ecstatic trance, and he sang the first line over and over and over and over and over, just like we chant japa. He just couldn't get away from the first line. And he went into deeper and deeper. And I had the sense I always had the microphone in me, and he was up there holding it like this. And the microphone was there, and as I was watching him, I had the sense that he was entering into the deepest realms of the purport of his prayer, realizing it much more than just the vibration of the prayer, but into the deeper meaning of the prayer. And an experience in Krishna consciousness that was a little treasure. It was something like this.
The treasure of divine love in Goloka Vrindavan has descended as the congregational chanting of Lord Hari's holy name. Why did my attraction for that chanting never come about? Day and night my heart burns in the fire of the poison of worldliness, and I have not accepted the meaning for relieving it. Lord Krishna, the son of the king of Raja, became the son of Sachi, and Balaram became the Thai. The holy name delivered all those souls who were lowly and wretched. The two sinners, Jagat and Madhai, are evidence of this.
O Lord Krishna, son of Nanda, accompanied by the daughter of Vrishabhanu, please be merciful to me now. Narottamadas says, O Lord, please do not push me away from your reddish lotus feet,
one that you look out and you take that. So I thought, you know, that was the right for us. Using our voice, the voice of our own soul. And sometimes the great vital personalities, especially the paramount speech of us, we run to this path on soul. This soul destiny, our unconditioned soul, we have so much access to that mood, we have to reflect on that mood. So that Shiva Parvati was the deep prayer, I find especially profound for us, because he came to the land of the Yamuna. He came to rest in his holy shore of piety. None. So he grew up at this point in 1896. And in a culture that lightning was very common. Every home in Calcutta, he could have a temple. Every single home. So it was just a matter of whether the female family stayed in a home or in a cluster of care. And he said everyone would have two of the families. And then he, in our stories, then he came to the land of Chagas and his dad. And we were feeling that when he supplied, he woke up and he supplied the same food. I think that's what we've seen so much. And I know we have another version of the story to record this historic moment. And the ashram of the wonderful Vaishnava. The Varshi Das, Nirmala Devi, and the Vani Devi. I know my dear, incredible desire for spiritual life and in your service to the Lord, to the other spiritual masters who have attracted the company of two wonderful souls who have just come around the spiritual tide of the gift that is sitting in front of us. And that is some of the original possessions, writings, and paraphernalia, so that was through the Prabhupada of the Buddhism. So, I think this is a really sweet idea. I wanted to take for the transcendental soul to the native. And we were very, very fortunate also to be here. So I think it would be really nice if you explain what you thought.